Hi, I'm Steve Jones and I'm going to show you how a thermometer works. In fact, the thermometer I've drawn here is a liquid in glass thermometer, which is the old type. And I acknowledge that there are many new types, but the principles are basically the same. In the principle that works with this one is the expansion of a liquid, and that depends on temperature. Obviously, as this liquid gets larger and expands, this liquid inside this thin tube goes up or down, depending on the temperature. Then what you need to do is you need some standard temperatures. And we have a standard temperature at 0 Celsius, which is the freezing point of water, 100 Celsius, the boiling point of water. So you can easily create a thermometer in this way, because this expansion should be uniform. So this is how a liquid in glass thermometer works. But of course, not only that, there are things called clinical thermometers. Now, a clinical thermometer is slightly different. It's basically the same in construction, but at the bottom it has a small constriction. It has a small piece where it goes very narrow in this tube. And what happens is, as it expands, it goes up to the reading of body temperature, and then when you remove it from the body, the thread breaks and it leaves some of the liquid in the thermometer tube at the top so that you can read the actual reading. It's a special device. That's why you have to shake it to get the liquid to go back into one place at the bottom. That's a clinical thermometer. You've also got maximum and minimum thermometers. And these were very useful, particularly in gardens, for determining the range of temperatures which occurred during the night when you weren't there to monitor them. And what they had was a mercury thread here, and above it was a little piece of very light metal which was fixed by a spring to the side, and this would be pushed up the tube, and once the reading had been taken, as this dropped down, this just stuck against the side of the tube and it told you where the mercury had got to. And that was a maximum it went to, and there was another type which did you the minimum as well. So those are different types of liquid and glass thermometer. Of course, we know that there are some thermometers which change, use the change in resistance of a piece of wire, and that depends on temperature too. But these type are rather more complex, and their workings are not so obvious and not so visible. So those type exist, and yes, have a look at them, but in terms of understanding, at least understand how the basic thermometer really does work.